Good day, everyone. We've been seeing a lot of disturbing news these days. And, you know, when we see anything like that, it's always easier to put the blame maybe on a school authority or authorities or everybody around us. But I think the buck finally stops with us. It is time we get together, we gather, we raise our voices, and people know that they are accountable to us. So one such citizen movement, it is not a movement by any particular organization, it is not a movement by any particular community, but it is a citizen movement. It is your movement, it is my movement, it is our movement. So let us all come together this evening. This is happening, of course, more details will be shared by Dr. Parul. I received the invitation from Dr. Parul, so I'm going to ask you, Dr. Parul, more about this movement.
So Not In My Name came into picture when, sadly, the Junaid episode happened. And, you know, there has been a spat and series of different kind of violences against religion, caste, minorities, so much negativity around. And this really got flared up and got people thinking, especially after the Junaid episode. And Sabha and Rahul started this campaign called Not In My Name, which is a citizen's voice saying that don't create hate and violence in my name. And there was a huge pour out at Jantar Mantar in June of this month. And then we realized that, you know, there are a lot of people who want to come out and say that we are Indian citizens, we are secular, we want the constitution's rights to be protected, right of religion, right of freedom, right of equality. And, you know, our silence should not be taken. So the Not In My Name movement is completely by citizen, for citizens. And that's why we are collecting here in Gurgaon today to spread that message all across India. What do you say, Shilpi? Why did you join, and what was your personal take on it?
So completely with you, Parul. So I've been like thinking a lot about the different kind of crime which has been happening. I mean, it has always happened, but the kind of limelight it has attracted over a period of time. It started more with communal picture to it, but for me, Not In My Name does not stop at a communal equality. It starts and stops with human equality. Now, whether we're talking about religion, whether we're talking about Dalits or Brahmins, or about gender, about elderly people, about women, I think it's, for me, it's more about vulnerability, which is in question today. You know, people who are more vulnerable get attacked. Everybody is silent because it doesn't happen to us at that point of time. So for me, Not In My Name is above just the communal harmony that we are spreading. And I think most of the citizens are with me on this today, especially with the incident which has happened yesterday in Gurgaon, sadly, you know, death of a 7-year-old child murdered brutally. I feel that people are realizing that it's not something which we see on TV. It can happen to any one of us at any point of time. So whether it was Pradyuman or whether it's Junaid, irrespective
Gauri
of
recently.
Gauri recently,
very shocking.
Irrespective of religion, age, profession, we have a right to live peacefully and in harmony.
Dr. Shibal, you have been actively promoting about this event as well. So what is your connection with this event? And
I do not think big things. I think the national narrative has simply been hijacked by the loony fringe. It's time sensible people started talking about the fact that we've all grown up together. I have never, ever known people to discriminate against me on the basis of nonsense. And that's suddenly happening, which is where we just need to make sure that the entire mindset is not taken over by people who are not representative of the way you and I think. I doubt any one of us would have problems sitting and having a meal with anybody from the other community or the other, any of the other things that we are discriminating against in today's world, and which is where we just need to make sure that we are heard. Just because we are silent does not mean we do not have an opinion. And it's time those of us who have an opinion, alternate to the one that is loud and vociferous and rabid and absolutely, for lack of a better word, crass, we be heard too, because we are, I am sure, the majority in this country.
No, and look at the dichotomy. At one side, we are talking about progressive India. So the focus should be on economic, social reforms.
Yes.
But because India is an emotional country, right? We largely run by our emotions. So there's this huge trend now to shift that focus onto negativity, focus and polarization on caste, gender, religion, minorities. I mean, any other country would not be focusing on those issues. It's not my concern what you're eating at your home or what we are cooking or cooking and the traditions that we follow. So it kind of takes away that focus of a nation on to more from the more important points to these which are not relevant. And how sad it is that we have to stand up again and ask for the basic right of constitution. What are we saying? We don't belong to any party. All what we are saying is that give us the freedom to follow what we are practicing back home. Don't take that negativity out in public and make it a issue, such a big issue. What, I mean, you lead a very large community and Gurgaon, you've been here so long. So what is your take on it, Neeta?
Definitely, you know, our voices need to be heard on an issue like this. And it has disturbed all of us at various levels. And I would say it is not just that issue. I mean, look at the number of crimes that is happening around us. So I definitely think an assembly like this is definitely required. And in fact, what is interesting about the whole thing that I saw is it's not any kind of protest. You have various artists who are coming together and who are performing. Could you please shed more light on who are the artists and what are the performances?
So it's lovely of these artists and a whole bunch of people who've joined in for today's event. And what better mode than, you know, culture and art and poetry and music and singing and dancing. I mean, I would rather sing and dance than be silent back at home. So, you know, we are all going to be there at Leisure Valley today, Gurgaon, which is gate number 2, the parking area where all the food trucks are. So from 6, we start and we have a wonderful lineup of some eminent artists there. So we have Trippy Summer, the band. Then we have Priya Kanong. We have... Priya Kanungo, Charyar, Mr. Madan Gopal Singh is going to be there. Then the favorite of all, Sanjay Rajora. People are really looking forward to hear him. There's a lot of music
Fosia
coming
there
in.
As well.
Fosia is there. There's a beautiful dastong kind of. It's a broadcast. It's based on Manto's rendition is going to be there. So it's going to be very engaging, very enthralling. So we request all of us to be there in large numbers, as many as can join in to say that, you know, we are Indians. Don't create hatred and violence in our name.
So let us remember, when we don't talk, democracy dies. So for democracy to stay alive, be there. Make your voices heard. We look forward to seeing you this evening.
Shilpi, you want to add something?
I just want to ask everybody to ask a question to themselves as to do they really feel that their neighbors, people from different community or people from different caste or background, do they really pose a threat to you? Don't go by what's being shown on media or what you read in the newspaper. Go with your experience. Have you experienced that? If you have not, believe me, most of us have not. So all this is a news which is fed. And I'll tell you my personal experience yesterday when I was sharing not in my name poster near my home, how two young people came and verbally abused me so badly. And these were not from opposite community. These were from my own community. So I was like, you know, really, you know, I kept my cool. And I also feel that, you know, the only way to address it, whether it's me, whether it's you, is to do with love and empathy. Whether we believe in it or we don't believe in it. If you don't believe in it, not in my name, show your opinion, express your opinion with love and empathy, not with aggression, not with violence. So question yourself, have you really experienced it? And do you really feel a threat by your neighbor who might not be from your community? I have not. And like you, Shibal, you know, I've grown up in a very cosmoculture in a township wherein we never knew that we were people from different communities. We really celebrated our diversity in the truest manner.
Yeah, what makes us such a wonderful and a dynamic community is that it's so heterogeneous. If it was just, you know, one people, it would be slightly stupid. Yeah. A, you would have less holidays in school, which would be really tragic. No, and this is not the legacy you want to leave for your children ever. Yeah. I mean, I don't know any one of us will ever sit our kid down and say,
I think most of us are sitting here to highlight that point also, because what are we leaving for the next legacy, the next generation?
Really sad.
Yes, so how they are getting conditioned.
Right.
So we can wind up and say that... today evening, look forward to having you there. White is the color of peace. So we are requesting everybody to turn out in white and join us at Leisure Valley today at 6 p.m. gate number 2 and the parking lot area. And
okay, so thank you for the information, Dr.
See you
Paul,
there.
Shibal and Shilpi.
Thank you.
See you guys.
See you there.